Power, power, wonder in power, in the precious blood of the Lamb. clap offering. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hosanna. Hosanna.
Show the way from me.
God we serve is alive again. He's alive again. D. Go to the next one. Just go to the next one. Go to the next one. Hallelujah. The Jesus we serve is alive. As we move more and more into the end times, we just need to keep remembering by faith when you hear things going wrong. TV and different situations. We need to hang on to our faith in Jesus Christ. Faith is not the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things unseen. Amen. He's alive again. Stone didn't roll away. He's alive again. He's no longer lame. He's alive again. Joyce.
Anybody else? enjoying your little devotional book.
Oh, thank you.
So, Mark, I don't know if you'd call it tidbits.
Tidbits, right.
Nice to read and reading them around the breakfast table, so.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Yes.
I guess I'd see one more little thing.
Okay.
It wasn't for a long-term taxi driver, I would be sitting here today.
Ah.
And it took a long, great journey.
Mark's faith. All right. Want to turn with me in your Bibles to Proverbs chapter 16?
Yeah.
Left out the end of 15 last week. Proverbs chapter 16. And verses. Solomon writing says, "The plans of the mind and the orderly thinking belong to men. But from the Lord comes the wise answer of the tongue." Men can think, and men can plan, and men can put everything in order that they see fitting in place. But Solomon, writing to his son, says, a wise answer comes from the tongue. And that wise answer comes from the Lord. And that's very important for us to understand and grasp a hold of. Because in the very next verse, he says, "All the ways of a man are pure in his own eyes. But the Lord weighs the spirits, the thoughts and intents of the heart, the motives." Always God checks our motives. Always he checks the thoughts and intents of our heart. They seem always right to ourselves. If you read through the Old Testament and you see where the nation of Israel would continually go astray time after time as they followed the prophets and the leaders that God had given them, there's always one little phrase that prefaces where they went astray. And it goes like this: "And every man did what was right in his own eyes." That's a continual problem we have as people. We always want to do what seems right in our own eyes, instead of what God says is right. And when we do that, we always, always get led astray. And what Solomon is writing here is what Paul actually quoted, where we're going to next in the book of Hebrews, is he was citing, God judges our motives, and he judges the intents of our heart. Now this is an interesting thing, because when we read in Romans where it says, "Don't judge, for the same manner that you judge, you will be judged," what those Greek words are really saying, if you would read it in the Greek, is don't judge the intent and motives of someone else. Because we know in the scriptures it says we're supposed to judge, and we will be judged by our actions, by the fruit that we bear. But what he's speaking of here, Solomon, and what Paul writes about also, is the intents and motives of a man's heart that God judges. That's not for us to judge. And so we need to understand these things as we walk as Christians. We can judge the fruit, what someone does, if it's right or wrong, but not the intents and motives of their heart. But the writers of Scripture come back to us and say, that's what God does. He always addresses the intents of our heart. Would you turn with me to Hebrews? Hebrews chapter 4. And we're going to pick it up in verse 12. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12. And Paul writing says, "For the word of God speaks and is alive and full of power." Always. Always the word of God is full of power and strength and might. And it judges us and it sorts us out. And it encourages us and it strengthens us and it teaches us. God speaks is alive and full of power, making it active, operative, energizing, and effective. I'm reading from the Amplified Version this morning. And it is sharper than any two-edged sword, penetrating to the dividing line of the breadth of life, the soul, and the immortal, the spirit, and of joints and marrow, and of the deepest parts of our nature, exposing and sifting and analyzing and judging the very thoughts and purposes of the heart. So you know why God doesn't want us to judge the motives and thoughts and intentions of a person? Because we haven't got the capability to judge it correctly.
That's right. Amen.
But God does.
Yes.
And when God judges, he always judges correctly and accurately, and he never makes a mistake. Verse 13. Not a creature exists that is concealed from God's sight. But all things are open and exposed, naked and defenseless to the eyes of him with whom we have to deal with. You see, you don't have to deal with me, even if I'm your pastor. But you have to deal with God.
Amen.
And you have to deal with him, and he will deal with you justly and correctly. And he will sift you, and he will analyze you. And he will expose you to the nakedness of your soul. And there is nothing you can hide from him. Absolutely nothing. And you will have to deal with him. And he goes on to say, inasmuch then as we have a great high priest. Now he's giving you some encouragement. Because he doesn't expose us and go into our motives and analyze us to destroy us. He goes into the very innermost parts of our soul and spirit, and heart and mind and thoughts and intents and motives, so that he can change them, so that he can cause them to be formed into a manner and a pattern of thinking that is profitable for us and profitable for him. He doesn't go in there to destroy us, and I want to emphasize that again. He goes there to shape and to form us into the image of Christ. That's why he called us. That's why he saved us. When he called us and saved us, he knew what was in there. He knew what was in the very most depths of your heart. Other people couldn't see it, but he could. And he saved you anyway. Saved me anyway. And if he saved me, he can keep me. And if he can keep me, he can change me. And if he can change me, he can present me glorious in his sight. Inasmuch then as we have a great high priest, that is Jesus, who already ascended and passed through the heavens, Jesus the Son of God, let us hold fast our confession of faith in Christ.
That's right.
For we do not have a high priest who is unable to understand and sympathize and have a shared feeling with our weaknesses. Isn't that wonderful? So he's saying, now I know you have weaknesses. And I identify with them. And I'm going to help you through them. And have shared feelings with our weaknesses and infirmities and liability to the assaults of temptation. You got that? We're all going to be tempted. Every one of us. Jesus knows that. And he can identify with them and help us through them, even when we fail in them. But the one who has been tempted in every respect as we were and are, yet he never sinned. So he knows all about what temptation is, but he never sinned. And since he never sinned, he knows how to help us who sin come up through it and bear up and resist it and overcome it. So what a wonderful verse, the next one. the throne room where we're coming to, because we have some things that aren't proper inside of us and things we need to deal with and things that God exposes into us, inaccessible and a place where we should hide from and stay away from. No, he says. As a matter of fact, he says just the opposite. Because he's there to help us. He's there to forgive. He's there to encourage. He's there to strengthen so we don't stay away. As a matter of fact, he says the opposite. Come boldly. And fearlessly. And confidently. Close to the throne of grace. For this is the throne of God's unmerited favor to us sinners. That we may receive mercy for our failures and find grace to help in good time for every need. What need? Read it again. And find grace to help in good time for every need. There is nothing that we cannot bring to him. Nothing he will not do for us. There's nothing we can, no need that we cannot bring to him. He tells us, bring everyone there to his throne of grace. And you will receive appropriate help and well-timed help coming just when you need it. I want to close with that again. Listen to this again. Let us then fearlessly and confidently and boldly draw near to the throne of grace. The throne of God's unmerited favor to us sinners, that we may receive mercy for our failures and find grace to help in good time for every need, appropriate help and well-timed help coming just when we need it. We're going to have a time of communion. And after we serve the communion emblems and partake of them together, I'm going to open the altar up here and I'm going to invite the musicians to come up after that. If you need help, if there's something that you need God to touch you in today, you come up and we'll pray for you and minister to you. Because today is a good day.
There you go.
It's an appropriate day for a time of help for any need you may have. And God says you come. I'm going to give you that grace that you need. Boy, can I ask you to come up and help us?
Thank you.
joy that we can receive. That we have entrance to send boldlessly and fearlessly before the throne of Almighty God. Because of your blood. Thank you. As Wally and the musicians sing some songs and play, if you have any needs and you want prayer, I invite you to come up and pray with you. Minister to you, and I trust God's going to do wonderful things that the needs that you have.
My little girl somewhere around. Is she downstairs?
That's right.
But I'll wait till she's back.
Okay.
Sing for her. Thank you, Lord. What's your first name? You said you just back.
Oh, Penny?
Yeah, Penny?
Penny.
Penny. I just wanted to say welcome back, Penny.
Thanks, Wally.
You betcha.
It's good to be
and,
back.
You bet. I'm going to sing a song. I'm not sure the key it's in here. I never brought my words with me, so I'm going to do it from memory if I can. And this is for you, Penny. What's your name again?
H.
H. Penny. Penny, I want to call you Penny. Have you failed in life's pathways to accomplish your plans? Is your heart heavy laden? Do you fear the Lord's command? Do you feel that no one loves you and there's no reason to try? Just give your cares to Jesus, your soul He'll satisfy. This is for everybody too. So pick up the broken pieces and bring them to the Lord. Pick up the broken pieces, trust in His holy word. He will put them back together, make your life complete. Just place the broken pieces at your Savior's feet. Pick up the broken pieces and bring them to the Lord. Pick up the broken pieces, trust in His holy word. He will put them back together and make your life complete. Just place the broken pieces at your Savior's feet. Just place the broken pieces at your Savior's feet. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Indeed. The God we serve is a big God. Amen?
Amen.
And he's bigger than every problem that we may come up against. Bigger than all my problems, bigger than all my fears. My God is bigger than any mountain that I cannot see. Bigger than all my questions, bigger than anything. My God is bigger than any mountain that I cannot see. Bigger than all the giants of fear and unbelief. God is bigger than any mountain that I cannot see. Bigger than all confusion, bigger than anything. My God is bigger than any mountain that I cannot see. Bigger than all my problems, bigger than all my fears. My God is bigger than any mountain that I cannot see. Bigger than all my questions, bigger than anything. My God is bigger than any mountain that I cannot see. Bigger than all the shadows that fall across my path. My God is bigger than any mountain that I cannot see. Bigger than all my hang-ups, bigger than bigger than all my questions, bigger than anything. My God is bigger than any mountain that I cannot see. My God is bigger than any mountain that I cannot see. Amen.
Amen.
He's bigger, amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I wrote a song a number of years ago, and I was just kind of feeling like, you know, we go to watch the hockey games, and we read the morning paper, and we do all sorts of things. And this one here is one I wrote. I'm just going to sing for you. This is one of the ones on my CD. I brought my CDs today. Anybody who's interested in a CD? It's called Why Do the People of This World Not Want to Serve You? And I was kind of feeling bad one night, wanting everybody to come and play and sing, and everybody was wanting to watch television.
Watch hockey.
What's that?
Watch the hockey.
Watch the hockey. All sorts of things. Why do the people of this world not want to serve you? Why do they not want to give their all in all? And you must hurt when you call on one to help you, but they're too caught up pleasures of this world. We must take time to read the morning paper. We must take time to hear the evening news. Philadelphia is playing tonight against the Oilers, but they don't take time to read his holy word. By the people of this world, I want to serve you. Why do they not want to give their all in all? you're too caught up in the pleasures of this world. We must go to church. Oh yeah, here it is. Come Sunday morning. I guess a little of the Lord would never hurt. Here it is, just as long as I don't have to go to the evening service. 'Cause the kids won't sit still, and Monday I have to work. What are the people of this world not want to serve you? Why do they not want to give their all in all? And you must hurt when you call. Well, one night I was kind of sitting around. I don't know how you guys will make it with this one, but it was "Give It a Whirl." I took the tune, took a chorus of the song, that old song called "Jesus Is the Sweetest Name I Know," and I kind of jazzed it up a little bit, and I put a couple other verses with it. So we'll just see how we make out. If you can do a walk bass, that'd be good. If not, there we go. Okay. Well, Jesus is sweetest name I know. Oh, 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 oh. And he's just the same as his lovely name. And that's the reason why I love him so, oh, 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 oh. 'Cause Jesus is the sweetest name I know. His name is Jesus, his name is Jesus, and he's the sweetest name that I know. His name is Jesus, his name is Jesus, he's the sweetest is See if you can figure out what's in my pocket, okay? Now I'm gonna take it out and put it back in my pocket, okay? Okay. So this little song says, I got something in my pocket. It belongs upon my face. So you gotta look really mean, okay, first. And when we take it out and put it on, then you gotta smile. Take it out, you try putting it on. Take it out and put it on. You go like that? But you gotta have a big smile. There you go. Okay, now take it off, put your hand over it, put it back in your pocket. You gotta look mean again. There you go, you got it. All right, here we go. All right, ready? I got something in my pocket. It belongs upon my face. Keep it here real handy in a most convenient place. You'll never ever guess it, no matter how you try. I'm gonna take it out, I'm gonna put it on. All right, let's take it out and put it on. Now, why it's a great Christian smile. Amen. Give her a hand. That's real good. You did real good. Thank you, sweetheart. All right. All right. Now she's got a smile. Look at that, eh? Bless the Lord. Okay, well, how many more songs do you want there, Dad?
Till you get tired of singing.
Till I get tired of singing. Oh, I see.
That can be till tonight, so.
Yeah. I want to do some songs that are fairly easy, so I'm not throwing a bunch of stuff at these guys here to, yeah, so I'm not working yet too hard. There's one there. It's called The Devil's in the Phone Booth, and he's dialing 911. He's in trouble today. I'll tell you, the church begins to pray. Amen. You begin to pray. And this guy just kind of thought of a little bit of humor that he said, the devil's in the phone booth and he's dialing 911. And the second verse says, and I don't want you to think I'm swearing, because it's just, if you look at it, when you first hear it, the first time I heard it, I thought, that guy's swearing, you know? And the line in the second verse says, what in hell would you want? In other words, the place called hell, what is there we would want? There's nothing. Okay? So I don't want you to think I'm swearing. When I got to I never wrote this song. Another fellow did. And it says, what in hell would you want? There's nothing there for me. Amen? And so praise the Lord. All right. There we go. Well, the devil's in the phone booth. The church is on their knees and they're loading up their spiritual guns. Well, the devil thought he had his tables a turn. Now Now he's on the run, the devil's in the phone booth. Dial 911. My life has changed since the Lord saved me. I proclaim the mighty name of Jesus Christ to everyone I see. You know the keys to the kingdom are the secret to success. Loose the Holy Ghost and son, devil's in the phone booth. Dial 911. Well, the devil's in the phone booth. Dial 911. The church is on their knees and they're loading up their spiritual guns. Well, the devil thought he had us, the tables are turned. Now he's on the run, the devil's in the phone booth. Satan sanctified me and the Holy Ghost has set me free. From the things of the world that are looking mighty good, the devil lied and said they were fun. Now the devil's in the phone booth. He's dialing 911. Well, the devil's in the phone booth. Dialing 911. Well, the church is on their knees, loading up their spiritual guns. Well, the devil thought he had us, but the tables are turned. Now he's on the run, the devil's in the phone booth. Dial 911. Yes, the devil's in the phone booth. Dial 911.
Amen. The devil's in the phone booth. Dial 911. Amen. Well, here's another cute little song for you. This is all about a grandmother. How many grandmothers we got today? Lots of grandmothers, eh? All right. Praise God. All right. There's some lyrics for this here. Maybe I better use this. Maybe we'll just sing it.
Well, my little Frenchie grandma gave her life to a family. 4 hours a day she...
Oh, we're in the wrong key, are we? Try G.
Well, my little Frenchie grandma gave her life to a family. 4 hours a day she farming. She got down on her knees. She couldn't read the word of God, but believed others read. And she wore out a big old family Bible, beating the devil over the head. Well, Grandma, Grandma laughed too late, oh, how she could pray. And if you talked about her, sweet Lord, why she sure had something to say. When we get to heaven on that bright eternal day, pray if the Lord gives us a mind to lead in prayer. Oh, Grandma, Grandma's kitchen was a special place, always plenty to eat. Humble, gumbalaya, jambalaya was a Louisiana Cajun feast. But the greatest thing about Grandma's house was the presence of the Holy Ghost. He believed in the saving, healing power. He had a double nose. Well, Grandma, Grandma let you lay. Oh, how she could pray. Talked about her sweet Lord, why she sure had something to say. When we get to heaven on that Friday, eternal day, if the Lord needs somebody to lead her, call the grandma left to lay. Now I used to play a little football down in Louisiana. My grandma used to watch me play, but she couldn't quite understand which one of those fellas I was, dressed so funny, acting so odd. But she prayed just the same for a football game. When it went, she'd say, praise God. Grandma, Grandma, let you lay. Oh, how she could pray. She talked about her sweet Lord, why she sure had something to say. When we get to heaven
doesn't matter to the leading man. Calling Grandma Lapchelaine. Well, Mama Grandma's gone to glory, and I know she's having a blast. Talking face to face with Jesus, she's finding home at last. And if I know my sweet grandma, she's telling them all about me. Saying, help that preacher boy stay in line, keep him on his knees. Well, Grandma, Grandma, naturally, oh, how she could pray. And if you talked about her sweet Lord, why she sure ain't something to say. When we get to heaven on that bright eternal day, if the Lord needs somebody to lead in prayer, he'll call on Grandma Lapchelaine. Give me that old-time religion. Give me that old-time religion. Give me that old-time religion. It's good enough for me.
This guy does harmony. We're just getting him going here. Praise the Lord. He's starting to get loosened up this time. Yeah. Yeah, we're going to have to get him a mic. You betcha. Praise the Lord. Okay. Well, you know something? When I go through good times and I'm up on the mountain, everything's great. But it's in valleys that get me every time. Amen? How about you? You find them valleys, they'll get you. So let's just listen to the words of the song here.
Life is so easy when you're up on the mountain and you've got peace of mind like you've never known. But when things change, still God in the night. close with that, amen? Is that good?
No. Yeah? I want a toe tapper to close
with. Oh, you want a toe tapper?
Yeah.
All right. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Oh, this little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let the little light shine. Hide it under a bush, oh no, I'm gonna let it shine. Hide it under a bush, oh no, I'm gonna let it shine.
Oh.